Everyone, Gabriel MC for Channel Fireball and Ultimate Guard, and today I'm back with a Pioneer video. I'm going to be playing Abzan Greasefang, which is a deck that Jan-Moritz Merkel, JMM, top 8 at Challenge with a couple of weeks ago. I side-posted a couple of good results as well, and I've played 2 leagues with the deck so far. I've been impressed. I think the deck is good. Funnily enough, both my leagues ended up the same way. I went 3-2 in both, and in both leagues my losses were once to the mirror and once to blue white control, where both times I misclicked. So kind of weird coincidence, but yeah, my other matches against some of the aggressive decks, etc., have gone quite well, and yeah, I'm gonna be playing this deck today. I'm gonna go over the list real quick. Pretty straightforward, just self-milled cards was Supplier, Wayfinder, Gracely Salvage, Witherbloom Command. You've got Rafine's Informant, which is your only way actually to discard Perhelion from your hand to your graveyard. So maybe that's one of the weaknesses of the deck compared to an Esper version or a Mardu version. You have less ways to discard the card. We've got, of course, Greasefang. And I guess I should explain the combo. Maybe some of you don't know the combo. So you've got really powerful legendary artifact vehicle, the Parhelion 2, which crews for 4. It attacks. It gives you 2 angels, also attacking when it attacks. So it's 13 damage. So basically, you're trying to bin the Parhelion and bring it back with Greasefang. Greasefang gets to crew it right away, and you attack with it. And the nice little upside of the green version is that you play 4 Chariot. I guess you can play Chariot even if you're not playing green, or maybe a light splash, but this is obviously one of your main colors. And pretty solid target for Greasefang, and also just pretty solid beatdown plan. I have won multiple games just curving out Supplier into Informant, into Greasefang, into Chariot, stuff like that. Typically maybe in against a deck like Rakdos, where they have a few discard spells or removal spells, but Chariot's just like a ton of value. And you bring back your creatures with Can't Stay Away. And, you know, even if your initial assault, I guess, doesn't work, it buys you a lot of time, puts them on the defensive, and then maybe you can assemble Greasefang, Perhelion later in the game. But yeah, I've been pretty impressed with the deck. I like the list a lot. I feel like every card makes sense. I'm not sure there's great, great replacements for any of them. I think maybe Seasoned Hallowblade could be better than Rafine's Informant, but I've liked drawing the card, and you get to discard a spell a lot with this deck, so it gets to be a 3/2 a decent amount of the time, which has come up. You know, it trades with something like a Graveyard Trespasser, for instance, or Bone Crusher Giant, so that was cool. The question for me right now, as far as the main deck goes, is the mana base. Do you want to play a basic swamp so you don't get punished too hard by cards like Field of Ruin? Do you want to play a card like Mana Confluence, which was not in the initial deck list, because despite being 3 colors and almost every land being a dual land, you want to play pretty low land count, because you have Wayfinder to find the land, you have Salvage and Witherbloom Command, so you want to play a pretty low land count, but you kind of need critical mass of lands just to have the right colors. You know, if you go too low on lands, you just not going to have enough color and mana. And even here, even with 2 mana confluence, it's a little shaky, but it works. As far as the sideboard goes, the rest, Fatal Push, Trespasser, Hearse, Sky Sovereign, and Abrupt Decay, kind of your usual suspects, I guess. Pretty good versatile sideboard cards. The initial list had 4 the rest. I'm going to try trimming one, because I found that even against blue-white control, I didn't exactly know what to board out, and I felt like I had a few too many cards. So I decided to add a 3rd Abrupt Decay, a 2nd Hearse for the mirror, and basically cut a Duress, as well as I cut the Force Witherbloom Command. There was the first Force Witherbloom Command in the sideboard. So yeah, I guess I played the mirror a couple times in 2 leagues, so up to a 2nd Hearse. Sky Sovereign is not for any really specific matchup. Maybe it can get rid of a Karn, but just pretty versatile. You can hard cast it pretty easily, and it's just another vehicle you can bring back. So you've got that synergy, you know, just you don't have to draw it. If you mill it, it can be good enough. So that's the deck. I'm gonna hop in a league, and not a prelim, actually prelim starts in a few hours. Pioneer League. There's been some construction going on for a while now, and hopefully there's not too noise. I hear a little banging right now. I'm not sure you can hear it with the filter. If they start drilling again, the filter is not going to cover that. So apologies in advance if there's some drilling noise. It shouldn't be too bad. But yeah, hope I don't jinx it. And yeah, while I wait for my first round opponent, I'd like to shout out the sponsors of this video. Ultimate Guard, they're amazing. They do great sleeves, deck boxes, whether it's kind of nice little slick like deck box like that. You've got the ones that are a little more sturdy, renewable materials. I've got a bunch behind me that Omni Hive, the like kind of bigger ones, the ones you can use for a cube or if you have multiple decks for your collection. Just really top quality product. You can check out all their stuff on ultimateguard.com, and they also have a very cool blog section. I might be a little biased because I'm one of the people who write for the blog section, but it'll be, you know, either strategy and, you know, kind of, yeah, more strategy oriented. It can be some story, maybe some of our older Pro Tour stories or how we started Magic. So you get people like me, Reed, LSV, Gabby, writing the blog, etc. So pretty cool ad on their websites. Oxy was Moxie. All right, they're rolling. They're playing first. They kept seven. I have a very good hand. Turn one Thoughtseize. Turn two Salvage. Turn three Greasefang. So hoping to draw Perhelion so I can discard it to Informant or just hit self-mill with Salvage. All right, Devil Push, Anvil. So lots of damage pretty fast. I feel like maybe I should just take the push for now. Just push gets rid of my Greasefang. Actually, Witherbloom Command. I didn't even realize. That's going to be good. So we know they have a Devil. A Devil alone is not super scary. If I play Thoughtseize, I'm kind of missing out on using my mana. So I think I'm going to go. Whenever one or more artifacts you can really. All right, I'm going to do the self mail and target polymer streak. This way, hoping to either hit a mill a land or at least a Perhelion if I don't hit a land. All right, I mill Perhelion. I'll take it. I don't especially need the land anyways. So I just figured like the parlay of, you know, me hitting a land and I'm happy I got a little value, or just me hitting like self-milling Perhelion. All right, one sure you need to make. One thing you need to make sure of is that you have your beginning of combat stop on Magic Online, because or else you bring back the Perhelion and you'll have a stop to crew it. I might or might not have gotten God the first time. I will not comment further. All right, red black sack. I'm not sure they're super reliant on the graveyard. They might have Cat Oven. So Hearse might be okay. Abrupt Decay seems kind of nice, but is it better than just having Witherbloom Commands and Thoughtseize? I'm also not sure what kind of graveyard hate they're going to have. Worst case would be to just have a bunch of Ley Lines of the Void. Let me see real quick. Me see if I can find a list or red black stack. Not a Rakdos midrange, a Rakdos sacrifice. That's a Giganta list, but well, Giganta is not gonna have Leyline. So I need to worry about Leyline and Goblank, I guess. Not sure I'm a fan of Thoughtseize in this matchup. It was kind of good there. I don't think I would mind a few extra Abrupt Decays, though. Kind of hard. There's not much you want to trim. Even Supplier seems kind of good in this matchup. Just kind of the velocity, I guess. Feel like not bringing in a few Abrupt Decays is asking for trouble, though. I will trim Thoughtseize, a Supplier, and Can't Stay Away, maybe. Kind of like Can't Stay Away in this deck. All right. Hopefully things come together. The Mulligan, the one drop. Dream, the turn two, technically, if you self-mill Greasefang and a vehicle. Do they have the mana to cast it? They do. And they're probably gonna sack synthesizers right away to get their anvils going. Give up the one card. Interesting. Right, I don't need more lands, right? I'll just take another Stitcher Supplier. That's kind of pretty big breaks. So I'm a little worried about Go Blank, but I think I should just still play Supplier. I could also just get really lucky here. I did mail the vehicles. I did not have a creature in the yard, though. All right, I guess I'm just gonna play Rafine's Informant. Oh, here's a Greasefang. Let's see if they have Go Blank. I'll discard Temple Garden and all right, just a devil. Can they kill a Greasefang on my turn? Don't feel like they can. Unless they have Fatal Push. That's kind of a good draw. Would take a lot of damage, but I don't think I'm gonna have to carry Zev. I want to save the life, so I'm just gonna play Takenuma. I want to save the two life. It's a second devil. Might be enough to kill me. Do your worst. Fatal push was their draw step. All right, I can gain one life. Did not mill another Parhelion. Bring back Grease Fang. I have Parhelion in the yard. I think they missed that part. I can bring back Chariots. Maybe that's enough to kill them. It was not though, but alright. I think they could maybe live one turn, right? The anvil gains them a life. And they can just block all my ground attackers. Maybe I just assume I was bringing back Parhelion. Alright, nice little start. Let's see what round 2's got in stock for us. Always nice to win the first one. The deck does mulligan a decent bit, but it also mulligans well. I don't think I need second Stitcher supply, right? I could just bottom land. I do have a Wayfinder. I don't hate it. Just kind of turbo self mill was can't stay away in my deck. But then I need to get to 5 mana to flashback can't stay away. Alright, I'll get rid of a supplier. And I think it's just maybe good to save Thoughtseize for later. Usually don't want to hit the 1 mana spell with Thoughtseize anyways. And maybe this way I just not draw them. I have some good mills and some good draw steps. There's can't stay away secured, that's nice. Every flavor of red black. Rip. Doesn't happen very often. It might be the first time it happens to me in free leagues. You kind of want to hit their free mana spells anyways, like Graveyard Trespasser probably is a card I'd be worried about here. Ooh, Grease Fang, that's a good draw. Let's see, how do I want to sequence that? I guess I should play Wayfinder first in case I draw Painless Green Source. Still no, see if they have a Trespasser. Ooh, Double Fable, Kalidas. If a non-token creature in open will die, though. None of their cards are super scary. So they're gonna play Fable next turn, but they have a second one anyways. So probably should take one of the four drops. What's scarier, Chandra or Kalidas? I think Kalidas probably still scariest. And then here, Don't attack. They're not going to block. Then they get to attack and I have to double block, which is... Maybe I should just save it for... attack. I'll attack and double block. That's fine. The next turn I can take it back and block the token. So I could play Grease Fang because I can't stay away. And kind of scared him into using Chandra Minus on it. But I think I'm just going to hold it. So I guess Trespasser is their best draw right now. They got rid of Fable and Harvester. They don't have Graveyard Hate or an Instant Speed Removal. If they didn't draw Fatal Push, it's all scary for them to attack here. Looks like they might have drawn something to get rid of Grease Fang. Damn, I made two more Grease Fang. I have all three Grease Fang in the yards. Still no vehicle. It's not happened very often. 8 cards, top 23. Not sure what the odds are, but... I'm guessing that's not very likely to happen. Yeah, Digital can't stay away. It's kind of nice. But let's see. Does it make sense to play the one from my hand? Saves me 2 life. I think it makes more sense to play one from the yard. The question is, do I bring back Wayfinder, which mails 4 cards and maybe gets me a land? Or that land could potentially be Takanuma as well. Or do I bring back a supplier, which potentially mails 6 cards, but doesn't give me a land? Grease Fang. All right, I think I'm going to bring back Stitcher Supplier. Taking a lot of damage too. Might just die to damage this game. All right, at least a Chariot. Probably is by now they're pretty likely to have a Fatal Push in hand. Oh, what a mistake. When it dies, it gets exiled. Whoopsie. Well, I didn't make that mistake yet. Making the mistake so you don't have to. My motto. That was bad. Fiend's Informant. I mean, I'll play it first. I could get lucky. All right. Have you drawn a Fatal Push? They have that treasure. They have. All right, I think I'm just dead to just damage, right? Even if I can bring back stuff. That's kind of unfortunate. Game one and the matchup in general has been good. Felt like that was kind of a fluke. It's really hard for them to stop you. Yeah, I mean. All right. Ooh, copy got Dark Dweller. That's pretty sick. All right, sideboard. I think the rest is okay. Think I've been cutting supplier. Maybe not all of them though. They might have hearse. I think Winterbloom Command is okay. I think Rub Decay is okay. It deals with stress faster. I forget exactly how I sideboarded in this matchup. Something like that. Maybe my own trespassers are okay. Winterbloom Command, does it kill anything? Doesn't really kill anything, right? It kills hearse, I guess. Maybe just have the Abrupt Decays in. And maybe still one or two Winterbloom commands. Let's see. There's really not much else. I guess the rest is not the greatest. Maybe keep in one supplier, one Winterbloom command. I guess the rest hits Go Blank, which is one of their scary cards. That's why I kind of liked having some of the rest. And then Trespasser, they have a few graveyard synergies and it just helps you stabilize a bit. Some draws you just like, you can win just curving Trespasser into Chariot too. Let's do that. Seems reasonable. Maybe Winterbloom Command. Maybe the rest would just be Winterbloom Command. Since it answers, ooh, no white mana. No white mana, but some spells I can cast. Is this gonna be my first loss against red black? Might be. All right, this time I'm gonna play it on turn one, given my hand. Lifebane Zombie, Rending Volley, Fable. Can't take Fable. Lifebane Zombie might just be a brick for them. Better white mana. I'll take the good card, I guess. Ah, they're playing scared. Oh, that's a nice draw. Super good draw. I guess I'm Rub Decay, right? You have to punish them heavily when they play so slow. They're just like costing themselves so much mana. I just curve creatures into Chariot. See if they have something. Seeker's Chariot. What a card. The hearse. The hearse. I wonder if I kill that, if I kill the hearse. Do I know anything about their hand still? I don't think so. Pathway's gone. So I'm sorry, dismissal. So I'll get the hearse. Oh, interacts with Trespasser. Well, that was easy. And obviously that was the other upside of getting rid of the hearse, that if I draw some self-mill card. It'll push. All right, I still get to crew chariot and attack for a lot. Oh yeah, I literally have lethal in play. Hearse rending volley. Some goblins too. I mean, I think one thing that's reasonable is to trim some of the graveyard stuff. But you don't want to overdo it. I guess free abrupt decay, I'm not sure it makes a ton of sense. Trade off Trespasser and Hearse, but Witherbloom Command gets rid of Hearse too with some value. Could just do the third, the rest too. All I can see always just a lot of value. Witherbloom Command gets a little worse without Citra Supplier. If you cast it onto, you're less likely to self-mill a land. It's tough. Boom. All right, I guess I won't go too heavy on, I won't go on max interaction, but it's all scary. Sometimes I'll just trim a Cancel and a Perhelion. All right, nutty potential. Go blank, harvester. Life Bean Zombie doesn't do a ton right now. I think it's just go blank. Maybe taking harvester. It gives them the treasure for the fatal push. Or the blood for the fatal push. And it gives them a 2-drop. Yeah, I think I maybe messed up there. Alright, playing Foreman. Hope not to draw Grease Fang. Ivan Zombie has not been very impressive this match. I mean, he's gonna have a bunch of other matchups. It's like mono white humans and stuff, mono green. Definitely blocking. All right, Grease Fang, easy. I guess I should Thoughtseize. Rending Volley or push. Just gonna take push. I hope Chariot carries me to victory. If they don't know something big this turn, I think I'll be okay. They need like Trespasser, Chandra, like a 4-drop, a Trespasser, a Fable, something like that. But did it not? Alright, when the cat attacks. So what does Intimidate do? Come block it. I mean, like I said, by artifacts and our creatures that share color, was it? I guess I can actually block this Chariot. That's pretty cool. I actually got rid of Rending Volley. Hurst. Not too scary. Let's see if they miss it. That Chariot can block Live Bane's on me. Alright, I think I should play Chariot pre-combat here for max damage. And I don't think they have Thoughtseize, but I could be wrong. Keep that one. Myself to see a land in their hand. No thanks. Keep the 2 cards in hand to encase it or go blank, even though go blank doesn't do a ton for them right now. I have 1 card in hand. I have 8, 10, 14 damage. If I Thoughtseize, I think I just win, right? I don't think they can have anything. As long as I keep the right Chariot. That didn't make me sweat it. Because like even if their last card is Fatal Push, they have to Fatal Push. I mean, I guess Fatal Push doesn't even do anything. What can they even have? I guess it didn't matter either way. Of course, feel free to leave a comment. Let me know what you think about the deck. Have you tried it? Have you played different versions? I know people ask if I like this version better than Esper or Mardu a lot, and I don't have an answer because I haven't played the Esper or Mardu version in Pioneer much. I've played these decks a bit in Explorer, but yeah, feel free to let me know if maybe you've played old versions a decent bit and have an opinion about it. Happy to hear it, even though I might not be able to answer the question, you know, which one's better. I just know this deck's been putting up good results. I've been pretty impressed so far with it. And yeah, if you like the content, feel free to give the video a like, maybe subscribe to the channel if you want to see more of that type of videos. You can also check out the sponsor, channelfireball.com. If you need to buy cards, they're a marketplace. You get to go on channelfireball.com, shop for the best price. You get to check out a bunch of you know, local game stores that put their listings on the website. And yeah, shop for the best price. Or if you have, you know, your local game store on the marketplace, you can support them too directly. So yeah, check out Channel Fireball. You can use my code at checkout, Yellow Hat. That helps me out. So that's pretty cool way to support me as well. All right, Monogreen. I actually haven't played the Monogreen matchup yet, so I have no idea, but it seems like Witherbloom Command is going to be very nice here. Slowed them down a lot. -1, -1, -3, -1. And a World Polo Heaven. I mean, seems worth it, right? Rather than develop my own game plan. Right now, if I had Greasefang in hand, maybe I would consider Grizzly Salvage, but that seems like it should buy me a lot of time, or a bit of time, enough time. All right, I could Grizzly Salvage main phase in case I had Stitcher Supplier. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That seems good. I mean, I'm hoping not to hit supplier. Obviously, I'm hoping to hit something better, but actually, was only supplier, so sometimes casting instant speed spells at sorcery speed pays off. Still nothing in the yard. Not a Greasefang, not a Parhelion. We're getting a little dicey. Looks like their draw was mostly mana. If they get a Karn, I'm probably in trouble. Yeah. Karn kind of stuffs my entire deck. I guess maybe that's why this deck's been doing well, just because Monogreen's not as popular anymore and Karn's really good against you. Can't activate the hearse and can't activate your thingies anymore. So that's kind of rough. Numa, Morkan stays away. Huh. And I guess I should keep self-milling, even though I'm not too sure how I get out of this mess. I mean, I'll play it out. It's just see, like, never played the matchup yet. That's definitely a matchup for Sky Sovereign, and I guess some duress. He could play Assassin's Trophy, Mythos of Nistroy. You know, there's cards that get rid of Planeswalkers, but once you start playing like these kind of clunky removal spells, gets all sketchy. Let's see, just Wayfinder, I guess. I mean, I'm not sure I can still win this game. I'll play out that game like one time, I guess, just to see. First time being in that spot. See if actually I don't even know. How would the matchup even play out in a weird way? Even if I hard cast Parhelion, doesn't know anything, I still can't crew it. How do I kill a Karn? I can't. Alright. Decklist check. Yeah, there's literally nothing I can do against a Karn, right? We are actually drilling, but the drilling is just slow enough that the filter is cutting it out, I think. All right, I do want to keep, like, it's weird because I want the Karn answers, but I also want to max out my potential to turn free someone. So maybe Chariot's the card that can go in this matchup because it's too weak. That would be... Huh. You saw what Witherbloom Command can do. That looked pretty cool. Chariot gets bricked really fast by a Cavalier, a Troll, etc. I don't think I want Push or Decay. Is it absurd just to board out all the Chariots? I kind of like it. Let's see, I bring back a Chariot on turn 3. I add a couple 2/2s. I get an attack in, then I cast it again. Alright. Let's do that. Let's do keep max potential for turn 3 Parhelion and at the same time have all the duress and the Witherbloom commands to buy me some time. I like that plan. Yeah, good hands. Question is, do I supplier? Karn's not coming down. Yeah, I think you go supplier salvage, and then if you don't have the combo, then you Thoughtseize to get rid of their potential Karn. All right, nothing good in the bin. We'll make those. I think you definitely want to do Grizzly Salvage over. We did not dodge. Hopefully it's not too bad or too long. Alright, I mean that's the downsides. I guess you turn three Chariots, you get enough creatures to kill a Karn. Alright, I used the almighty powerful mute button since the filter wasn't doing it. I think I maybe made a mistake here. I should have cast Wayfinder first to see what I mill and see if I'm hitting them with Parhelion next turn, and that would have helped me make a better decision on Thoughtseize. So Cura lets them ramp into Storm. Troll doesn't do anything on its own, so I'm not taking the Troll. So I feel like it's Cura or Storm the Festival. 1, 2, 3, 4. Troll heads on cast Storm. All right, I guess I'm going to take the Storm. All right, no lands, but I'll take it. Parhelion in the graveyard. So I think we're good. Let's see if they can beat it. I mean, obviously if they drew Karn, they can beat it, but what if they didn't draw Karn? All right, do I want to get one extra damage in with Supplier and Wayfinder here? Are they getting any better? Are these creatures going to help me? I'm not sure. Guess I'll get some damage in while I can. You know what? Maybe I should attack just with Supplier. Maybe they don't block. All right, 5. That's 6, 7 mana. Kind of obnoxious, the people who bought the apartment above ours. They're in a bunch of construction when the people before them did like a bunch of construction like 3 or 4 years ago when they bought it. So it's like, why would you buy, like, probably pay more for an apartment that just got redone and then you're gonna redo everything too? Like, kind of weird. You're basically paying for like the work they done, plus you're doing some work as well. All right, fancy, fancy. But do you have anything? Do you have anything that matters? Like, even Karn here is not good enough, right? I guess Karn minus. If you have anything that blocks an angel, gain some life. I guess we're about to find out. This, okay. Damn, did they have 10 mana? Karn? Nykthos. Have they not played a land yet? Wow. They have 10 mana. Wow, well played. Very nice. Karn and Cavalier. Wow. That was... felt pretty unlucky that they had all that. They needed a lot there. Wow. They needed a freaking lot. It's not even like I self-milled the rest this game, so you could argue like maybe Chariot would have been the rest or something like that, but... Damn, I can't believe... Well, that just happened. Well, I can't believe it, but kind of unfortunate. I think taking the storm the first time around was still good. But in hindsight, maybe not. Maybe even taking troll was the play. But then I let them go Curine too. Oh, maybe I messed up. Picked apart. And they have an extra blocker. Looks like it's over. I don't think I can win. I guess I have Visayu, but damn, I even have Visayu to get rid of a blocker. Still not enough. That's sick. I just realized if I had had one more untapped mana. Wait, did I have one more untapped mana? I didn't try it. I could have like Besage for one, like even just Besage the Forest was Wolf Willow on it, would have been good enough. I totally didn't even consider. I mean, I didn't have the mana, but I might have missed it if I had the mana. That's kind of cool. Now though, can I deal the last point of damage somehow? And I can just attack with everyone, right? I need, yeah. I need to attack with everyone and hope they crew the boat. Which it might do, right? It would make sense. It would make sense for them to crew the boat here to not go down to one. Wow. Nice play. Damn, nice play. I had it. I mean, I have Witherbloom Command in my deck. That's kind of nuts that they went down to one instead of trying to block. Do they know about the Besage somehow? Okay, I mean, I can still win this Witherbloom Command. How do I draw a Witherbloom Command, though? Damn it, such a. I don't know if it's a read they had or if they just didn't even think about it. I mean, I think I just lose now. I'm not sure. I'm not sure if I can still live a turn or not. Let's see. Yeah, I'm curious to know if they like thought about Witherbloom Command, thought about Besage, just didn't think about anything at all, didn't forget they could just crew Sky Sovereign. Then you have to play it out. Damn, one damage. Did I miss one damage at any point? I don't think so. That's so sick they didn't try and block the two angels. So sick, Elki. Oh, I can't even, So killing it doesn't even do anything, right? Oh. Oh, I'm an idiot. Oops. Oh, I didn't know what that. I didn't realize what it. Well, I realized what it did. I just didn't think about Cura, though. So I gave them a free activation on Karn, and now they can just. Man, maybe if I don't do that free activity, I get an untap step. I might scoop and just look at my top card and see what it was. Did I win a game? I didn't win a game, right? So it's like 2-0. Honestly, I don't think it's that bad because sure, once they have Karn and stuff and they can go over the top even, but they also have, you can just goldfish and have nothing to stop your goldfish. So you've got that going for you. And the disruption, and also it's my first time playing the matchup, so maybe my sideboard strat's a little off. Maybe Chariot is good, just getting a few 2/2s and stuff and being able to attack their planeswalkers. Especially maybe coupled with discard spells. Should I just scoop? I mean, I gotta assume. They plussed. They just kill me, maybe? Probably would have been okay. Yeah, might have been okay if I didn't give them that free activation. I'd gotten the chain veil right away. I know Harry MTG, who I have a podcast, I do a podcast with, and he plays that deck a lot, and he's not, I don't think he's super sold on the Chain Veil. Think there's a like Cauldron too you can play. I'm not sure which one's better, or if you want both or neither. Kill one. I have two blockers. I block the two. I block this and that. I take. I mean, I'm not dead on board. I only take 13. Well, looks like I get a shot at Witherbloom Command. Do I have a way to get rid of a Cavalier? Is it worth keeping a. I don't think I have a way to get rid of a Cavalier, right? I'm trying to think if it's worth it to keep the Angel. I think it's just Witherbloom Command or bust. All right, I didn't mill a Witherbloom Command. 1 in 12. Maybe I have more. 1 in 12 shots. Ah, a little late. I can't stay away. I don't have creature that pings for one. Nothing. It's unfortunate. Can kill a Karn. All right, GG's. Well, what a close game. All right, no trophy today. But let's see if I can finish strong anyways. Monogreen. Monogreen's been way less popular. I think I was looking at the Pioneer Challenge results for past weekend, and there was, I think, maybe a couple monogreens in the top 32 both days. Not sure if it was 2 and 2 or. So maybe 4 out of 64 top 32 decks. It's like 7%, 8% of the field. It's funny, like if a few weeks ago, a couple months ago, maybe people were like, "A monogreen's too good." This, that, monogreen's like almost gone from the meta right now. I've been playing blue-white control. The list close to the list I played it in the Pioneer Showcase. I went 7-3, so not bad. And blue-white did pretty well overall. So I still like the 60-card list. I played against a lot of aggressive decks. And having four portable holes in my 60 card was definitely a big deal. I also had two Cellular Wreckage in my sideboard, which were kind of MVP for me all day. Played against a ton of aggro. It makes them. makes the white-red heroic matchup pretty easy, which is popular deck right now. All right, let's see. Probably want to keep all my spells. And against Yurion, don't want to keep Mana Confluence over Pathway. I think this is good. Temple Garden in black. Let's me cast pretty much everything. Oh, blue-black. Spur could be rough. They might have some, like, Graveyard Hate in the main. They might have Goblanks, Chaos, something like that. We'll see. I have not played a matchup. I've played blue-white twice. Lost both times. Both times was really close, and both times I made a game-losing misclick. Oh, Proving Ground. Well, that was a great draw. Could they be Niv, maybe? I played a league with Niv Yurion. It was not good. I was, I think I went 0-6 in games. I think I went 0-2. And it was a list of someone who had been doing well, too. So it's not like it was like lists I build that never did well in anything. Glasspool Mimic. Alright. Officially confused. Second Grease Fang? No. I guess it's just Wayfinder. Wayfinder, cast Wayfinder. Rip. Kind of unfortunate. Could come up this game. Flashing back, can't stay away and stuff. Keep making our land drops, play multiple spells in a turn. Oh, are they playing? Oh, they're playing Enigmatic Incarnation, right? That's why they have the Mimic. It's kind of scary. If I don't have a fast draw, I can maybe just go over the top, honestly. Not sure what they're getting, but they put two to the bottom with Omen. That's good news. Enigmatic Incarnation is a really cool card. I used to play that deck a bit on Arena. I think it was in Historic. It's kind of good in some matchups, so it's pretty good. But then I think it had very struggled against counters, disputes, like people disputing your 4-mana, 5-mana cards is rough. All right, opponents, we're doing so good so far. Playing at a decent pace. Decent pace games and matches. Let's go. No. It's chilling. Okay, Shoggala Shrine. Surely you decided what you wanted to do at this point. Fires of Invention. Seems weird that it would take someone so long to go. Are they joking?
As they were just gone doing something else. Didn't seem like that tough of a turn. Maybe they're looking at their deck, see what they can get to stop Greasefang. Let's see, do you have anything good? Blood Mage. They can Uriel and Blink the Blood Mage again. I guess I should kill it and self-mill. Just not great, fish fabric on lands. Let's see what they can do. Let's see how bad it gets for me. That card never really saw a ton of play. It needed a little extra something. Not sure what they could have done to make that card good. I mean, I guess the obvious one was choose two mode. That's probably a little too good. Choose two mode is too good. Make the first mode two pests instead of one pest. Maybe too good. Well, they could have started by doing just draw a card instead of draw a card, lose a life. I guess that would have been like a little something. And then I guess they could have just give it more power and toughness. I don't think making that card a 3/2 would have been like totally insane. Like 3/2 draw a card, lose a life. It used to be like Rogue Refiner, right? 3/2, 3/1, 2/2. Yeah, maybe something like that. Give it an extra point of power or toughness, and then maybe you remove the lose one life from the draw ability. All right, let's see what they get this time. Sacking Fires. Scarab God was mana up. At least it only exiles creatures, so we can mill a Parhelion. Might be in business. I've not milled a Parhelion. We can go. Self-mail, kill Omen. Get back with Seiji. That's pretty cool, actually. Fortunately, I mean, if they let them on tap, I'm just kind of die, right? So I guess I have to play Greasefang. Bring back Chariot just to get a couple 2/2s, yikes. Not too sure how I win this game, but I'll try. Alright, I've literally yeah, I'm dumb. I mean, not that I could do much. I was so focused on my yard that they're still at 20, so even if I get really lucky, I wonder if they're gonna have rest in peace in their sideboard, probably. Alright. That's more than enough. That was already enough. Yeah, I should keep in the Wetherbloom command. They're gonna have a few, I think they're gonna have some of the green enchantments that cantrip and stuff. Let's see. Probably on the rest. And probably want to keep Wetherbloom commands. I don't think I want to Brub Decay. You like Trim a Chariot, Trim a Can't Stay Away, and Trim a Wetherbloom commands. Let's see that. My friends tell me you're the gamest. I don't even know what to say, just smiley face. It's always nice. Always nice when people say nice things. But yeah, well, my opponent's figuring out how to sideboard. If you like the video, definitely consider liking the video, subscribing to the channel. This video is also brought to you by channelfireball.com and ultimateguard.com. And you can support my content and, you know, other CFBG content creators content by engaging with CFB and Ultimate Guard. And on top of everything, they have great service and great products. So doing me a favor, doing you a favor, definitely check out ultimateguard.com if you're interested in sleeves, deck boxes, all that good stuff. That's kind of brutal when they went in the tank. Remember that? When they went in the tank, I thought like, oh, maybe they have a tough decision, and they're just like, nope. Fires. Incarnation. Here we go. All right, I'll keep. I have not the most stacked hand, but that's some not draw potential. Good enough. Did board out one Can't Stay Away, so I have less potential for like hitting a self mill card, hitting a grease fang, etc. Mulligan side seems like the kind of game I can maybe just win it with a chariot when they mulligan to five like that. Just curving into a chariot at this point. Even their deck is really powerful, like can probably like generate a lot of power with few cards. I'm just gonna take Omen, I guess. Kind of tempting to take something like a Blood Mage, but I mean, they're so low on resources. Plus, they're playing 80 cards, so they have a lot more variance on their draw steps. Oh, I messed up. Oh no, I didn't mess up. I was gonna say I got a mail can't stay away and grease thing, but it's not how can't stay away works. Alright, taking a moment of the C worked out. Maybe that's actually good for me. Kind of. I guess it's double-edged sword, but I'm definitely gonna do it. They just can't have that many untapped black source in their deck. And yeah, just keep the pressure on. Alright, nice. Well, nice. I'd like to win in a more honorable way, I guess, but I'll take it. Alright, still no grease thing in the yards, no. Not even a random creature to get back with can't stay away. Alright, duress check. Ooh. I wonder how many blood mages they have. Surely they can't have that many. Maybe Weatherbloom Command's just too bad. Unless I think they have Rest in Peace. They're playing Scarab God, they're playing Blood Mage. Have to discard spells. No ways to get rid of a Rest in Peace except turn one discard. What makes sense for an enchantment deck to have Rest in Peace? You play it in the early game, then maybe later you sack it. Good trim on supplier, edge a tiny bit. And I guess if I'm boarding out supplier, can't see what gets a little worse. All right, let's do that. I used to trim Wayfinder here and there, but seems like it's all too good of a card to trim. Alright, really good hands. Pretty much as good as it gets. I guess it could have Ley Lines too. Ley Lines Incarnation. That makes sense. Are they mulliganing to 5 again? Wow. I mean, sure, you're playing 80 cards, Yuri on 5 colors and some weird cards, but back-to-back mulligans 5 is rough. Let's see if they can somehow come back. Well, at least they can cast their cards this game. Maybe they draw spells. No! One turn too early. Let's see. Something very satisfying about, like, clicking the cards that people play, keeping track. All right, Yurion in your hand, or did you draw something good? No. All right, let's go. Land in my hand, unfortunately. Anything else? I think I can take Swamp here. I don't think you want to take Takenuma because you can get it back with Witherbloom Commands. I'm almost definitely gonna have to play out land because I'm probably just gonna cast Grace Fang next turn. Wow. It's kind of brutal. Yeah, I'll just cast Grease Fang because this way next turn I can, if I draw a land, I can just cast Chariot. If I don't draw a land, I can pre-combat Witherbloom Command and maybe self-mail a vehicle, even though it's looking less and less likely. Also, if I draw Informant, I get to discard Perhelion. If I, another self-mail card, maybe I'll self-mail some more. Fire is okay. All right, hit me, dealer. Damn, not even on tap green to cast Witherbloom Command. It's kind of brutal. I don't know if I should be complaining in some mulligan to five, but my draws have basically been like, I'm basically on the mulligan to five right now. All right, at least they still have Foundry Yurion and then two mystery cards. Well, Sefkai would be really good for them. All really good. Blight on my land. That's one spell. Let's see if they cast their Yurion right away. Blocks an angel, buys them a lot of time if I... And draws them the card right away, buys them a lot of time. If you have nothing else, you probably have to cast Yurion right away. Well, you have something else. I wonder what they're even going to get. Like, Blood Mage doesn't do a ton. My graveyard sucks. Skyclave, yeah. Wow. Oh, man. Brutal. I have untapped green in my yard, I do. It's like Living End, right? It's the Living End nightmare when you just draw all your Living Ends or self-mill all your Living Ends was... Wow. Free for Helion. Assuming this game's over. Mill a bunch of crap, draw par Helion, mill a bunch of... well. Lost to the mulligan to five. Deck is clearly trash. Scratch it. No, I think the deck is good. I think green. I think I've ran like kind of bad overall. Haven't had too many of the super good crazy draws. I kind of want to scoop. I'm not sure I can honestly win. All right, I'm just going to scoop. All right, GG's.
GG's. That was a little frustrating, not gonna lie. Mean, I'd rather mulligan five and have a functional hand than just draw like that, but well. Shows kind of the limits of the deck. You just have so few ways to get rid of the Parhelion. It does come up a lot. It definitely does come up a lot. I don't know if there's a good blood card you can play, blood token card you can play. They're mostly red, right? Don't really want to talk. Try to free Parhelion and then they come and don't even know. I've only played like for 14 matches. I feel bad, but sometimes you don't feel like being all chit chatty. Oh, and I missed my match. Damn it. I like to joke that I'm not Reed Duke. I'm not always capable to put up a smile and be really nice after a frustrating loss. Red black again. On head trespasser, yeah, I'll play. I guess I play Thoughtseize first because I want to be able to like Thoughtseize into Grisly. Wow, to have Hearse in the main and trespasser in hand. Dang. All right, I guess I'm glad I mean, I guess I have free Winterbloom command in the deck. Okay, we know they have Trespasser, so I don't want to just. Why would I main phase anyways? But even more so, because we know they have Trespasser. Right, let's see if I can turn it around here. Get some good hits. I have a Chariot in the yard, and I can't stay away. No grease fang though. Right, I guess I'll play Informant first in case I draw Thoughtseize. And I'll discard it even though I might lose it. We'll play a Stitcher Supplier, hope to maybe nail another Parhelion. All right, this game's not going super well.
Not ultra blocking is good here. I just blocked out of habit. Both Jared in hand. Don't really care that much. I'm not sure. Wait, do we know about Fatal Push? We do know about Fatal Push. That was a bad block. It was a free two. Really bad block, actually. Well. Not sure what to do, honestly. Should I just play Greasefang and stay good? And they can copy Trespasser. They get to exile Can't Stay Away. And my Greasefang. No graveyard. Then they get to do it at instant speeds. Jeez, what a nightmare. What an actual nightmare. Man, I don't even know how I'm supposed to get lucky this game. How do I get lucky? This insult, add insult to injury. Do you even want to attack with chariots? And Kiki Jiki Trespasser just kind of owns me. Let's see, can I win? Can I still win? Or am I pretty much locked out of the game? Did I bin a Bosseju at some point? When I took Greasefang, right? I took a creature over it. And maybe Witherbloom command, get back Bosseju, kill Kiki Jiki. I mean, that seems so far away. I don't even really need to kill the Greasefang to use their Fatal Push. Oh, I don't even have a thing in the yard. Alright, I'm just gonna skip this game. I don't think I can win.
Let's get rid of supplier. One perhelion, one can stay away. On the rest. Have I even been doing Trespasser in this matchup? I think I have. Maybe no Sky Sovereign. Kind of like the rest. There's a lot to take. Removal, Fable, Hearst, Sold Goods. You won't have supply for the rest a lot, but I think in game one, supplier is good. That happens a lot with some decks where you have a card you board out a lot for the same card in a lot of matchups, but just like one card's a good game one card, and then it gets much worse off your sideboard, and typically like graveyard based deck too. People have more graveyard hate. So it's not like necessarily a mistake to build your deck that way. Alright, this lane's been rough, but I still haven't lost to red black, so let's see if we can keep that streak alive. Okay. I see a not draw potential. Obviously they could have more than one disruptive card. Could have like Rending Volley plus discard. The rest doesn't do anything. Nothing in their hand really does anything. So what's the best cards? Might still be the rest. They take Vimba Parhelion. So if they draw Hearse, that double push. What can they even draw? Hearse would be the worst, but there's not much I can do about it. Maybe go blank if I get unlucky and miss my third land drop. At least I don't lose my graveyard and they still have kind of a useless hand. But then Trespasser does the same thing. I guess I'll just take duress. I don't know. Seems kind of bad. Maybe take a push. This way they don't push my informant. Alright, that's good news. And that's good news. Alright, we just need to dodge like a hearse or a rending volley. Nice. Oops. Could kill a blood token. Should probably just drain for two, right? Drain for two mill. We need to rest them first. Blank Trespasser. This
So another Witherbloom command is lethal. Oh, you know what I should do? I should keep Witherbloom command. Because if I target Trespasser, I get two wards. All right, well, that also works. I never thought about the ward interaction, and that's why I did not play Trespasser first. Because there's nothing I can have. I mean, I could have another Grease Fang, I guess. Here's the reasoning is you want to get rid of my Grease Fang if you're going to kill my Grease Fang, so I don't just play it again. Yeah, I mean, I think same deal, honestly. Even though it was nice to have Parhelion, it's like, you're like, oh, maybe I should have all the Parhelions to maximize turn 3 Parhelion. Good stuff. You also want to make your deck decent in the grindy games. This hand's fine. Okay, understood. Try to play the one that's card advantage first, I guess. In case I get hit by a go blank. Fable's pretty obnoxious. Witherbloom command doesn't do a ton for me. I mean, I could discard Chariot and try and get really lucky. Seems kind of short-sighted, though. Just discard Confluence, maybe. Let's see, go. What the hell was that main phase stomp? So weird. Just discard one. Okay. Okay, this time I really want to block. If they let me. Hearst is not too big of a deal right now. I think I should play Chariot first, right? If you can kill my Chariot and exile it right away, it's a little annoying, but I guess it's a risk I'm willing to take. I don't know, maybe I should have just gambled and gone all in on discarding Chariot and hoping they don't have like removal, graveyard hate, anything. I mean, I guess they would have had Hearse for the Chariot, right? They would have already backfired. All right. Green, black. I can
Do that. Gonna exile the two lands and hope I don't mill another one, I guess. Oh, no. Didn't even do that. Seems a little loose. Wait, why are they crewing it? Oh, it becomes a creature. Who's playing loose now? Oh, wow. I didn't even realize that. Well, learning experience. I guess it could have worked out right. I could have milled something good. This is looking kind of grim now. This is looking extremely grim. Did they have a shot to kill it when they didn't have a creature? I think they always had a creature, right? They didn't attack last turn. Alright, I guess I'm just going to attack with everyone getting a little desperate here. This way, if they don't block the chariot, my chariot gets to live. If they block the chariot, I get some extra damage in. Yeah, I guess in hindsight, I was supposed to save my Witherbloom command for later in the game. Try to Witherbloom command, force them to... I mean, I guess they could have just activated, right? They also kind of messed up in some ways, even though it was unlikely for them to, likely for it to matter. They could have just activated and skipped it untapped. It's a copy, right? The token. This game just got a little more complicated. All right. They got me today. That was definitely my worst league was the deck. The first two leagues was just like losing to the mirror, losing like close matches against Blue White where I messed up. This was just like deck not being super functional, running into some toughish matchups, I guess. Some good draws. Whoa, stop dropping stuff, please. I live. Doesn't bother me too much. Usually it stops by the time I start my afternoon stream, but I probably don't even realize there's someone here that like is at home all day. Maybe I should have gone and told them and be a little more careful. It's never been too bad though. Okay. Say that and the drilling starts. All right, have I been officially picked apart here? Like the Reflection was Harvester, Hearse Untapped. I brought in all the Abrupt Decays too, right? No, okay, I guess that's a reason to bring in Abrupt Decay. Yeah, that's pretty cool though. And I guess Sky Sovereign looks like it could be good too in these games anyways. All right, GG's. Yeah, maybe have all the Abrupt Decays. I never even thought about that. I always like, I think no one pointed out in my chat too. I always like, oh, Witherbloom Command deals with Hearse. Witherbloom Command deals with Hearse. It's just not always the case. But yeah, I'm not too sure how it changed the deck to fix some of the problems we've had this league. I think the list is still pretty solid.
maybe have a real plan B sideboard plan with more trespassers, but I'm not sure that's what you want to be doing. Just find the right balance and stuff. But yeah, it looks like the ring's gonna start. So I guess this is it for me this week. If you made it this far, thank you so much for watching. I hope you all have a great weekend, a great week. From vacation, enjoy. If you're not, be strong. And yeah, take care, everyone. I'll see you next time.